what you're going to need for this is sur papier, a staple gun for stapling this, the wallpaper, onto the wood, hinges, you know, for the doors to flip in and out, and then like wood glue, you know. So we're going to need that, and the staple gun, and then a wallpaper of your choice or fabric. So yeah, and then this comes with the small nails inside. So, and you're going to need a screwdriver. A screwdriver for the hinges, and also if you're not going to use glue, you need 12 screws. Wood should be 8 centimeters thick all around, just for stability. You need 4 pieces of wood of 170 centimeters in height or in length.
Would you rescue me? Would you get my back? Would you take my call when I start to crack? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me when I'm by myself? When I need your love, if I need your help, would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? We don't talk much, not anymore. Broken bottles and slamming doors, but we still care about each other. Say we care about each other. I know life took us far away, but I still dream about the good old days when we took care of each other. We were living for each other. But
it's time to arrange everything for gluing and for screwing in. For one section, I'm gonna need 4 of these to arrange. Mark a line to use as a guideline for aligning your wood pieces together so that they are correctly aligned. Also, make sure that the first piece of wood is on the inside, not at the top, for support. Make sure to measure in between so that everything is the same height, you know, for stability. I left a gap of 53 centimeters in between each, you know, so you can do the same. To save time, you can use a screwdriver. Okay, it's time to glue. Make sure you put glue on every side, even on the boat, the ones on the inside. Everything has to have glue.
This is crucial to press really hard to make sure that things stick. Now I'm going to do all the rest and wait for it for 24 hours. And then I'll paint it too in those 24 hours after like maybe 12 hours have passed. Okay, right now I'm checking to make sure the glue has stuck after the 24 hours.
So basically this is how it's supposed to be. Those are the legs right there at the bottom. And this is the front.
Now that the glue has done its magic, it's time to paint. This is optional, you don't have to do it. I was not planning on doing it, but still I decided to do it. So
see, like this is the green, like kind of like that, but to match that a bit, you know.
Do the rest and you're good to go.
So as you can tell, the shelves have been painted, or I don't know how to call them, but the most important thing you need to paint are only the legs. You don't have to paint everything, but I painted it for my own sake. So after painting, now we are going to first screw on the, you know, the hinges for turning. We're gonna be putting this on.
I marked the holes where the hinges were going to come, and I did try the hinges out to see how I was going to position them to make sure they could turn the right way. Using a marker, I used the nail of the hinges to mark how long I have to drill, and I marked it on to make sure I don't go any further. So make sure to do that. Now I'm going to do everything, all the rest, you know, doing the screws and so on, and then you'll see the result.
don't know if this is gonna work or not. I'm a little bit nervous. If the doors don't really do this clapping back thing, I'm fucked. Okay, let's see. I'm so nervous. Let's try. Oh God, please work. Let me show you. It has worked. Let me first give you like the full, because you can see. Show you from up close. So these are like the, I don't know how to call the things, the hinges. So they are in.
Now we are going to add the wallpaper. I don't know how I'm gonna do that, so I have to first figure that out on my own, and then I'll film once I've figured how I'm gonna put it on.
This is how I'm going to do it. I don't know if I like it that much, but you get the idea. So it's gonna be folding in, so you can see the green part. Or maybe I shouldn't do the full green part and just a bit. And then this is gonna go in, you see that? So I'm gonna staple this like that, you see? So, and then I'm gonna staple it here in the middle, and then there, and then there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold the wallpaper on the sides so that it fits in between, so you can still see the green line of the wood. So I'm using wallpaper because it's easy to change if I want a different look, but you can use fabric or whatever you have of your choice. And my biggest mistake, I should have done this before adding on the hinges, because when you're using a staple gun, it uses a lot of power. Also on the back side, so like when you open it on the back, you can see that it's pretty, but I'm not gonna do that right now. I'm just a bit too lazy to do it, so only the front. If I have time another time, next time, then I'll do the back. But for now, it just needs to cover what needs to be hidden. So.
Okay, so now you can see the edges. I'm gonna staple those with a staple gun. I hope the thing works, because I'm a little bit scared that it might explode.
This, you staple also in the middle, and then here also, there, and right there. So,
okay, so this is how it looks on the inside. As you see, it's a bit folded in. I could have done double, but I'm just not in the mood. So, that's how it looks on the inside. Now, I'm gonna do the other part, and we're gonna start.
it looks like. I wanted to go for something that kind of blends in like this and this. I probably should have made a third one to go right there, but for now, I think it's good. So I'm happy. I'm really happy about it.
You got it. We got the magic.